What's going on, Leafer Nation? It's Leafer back again, and welcome back to another video. And for last event, I made a video, so for this event, I'm going to do the same exact thing. There is a new event that EA just released, and it is called the NHL Playoff Predictor Event. So as you can see, each team gets one player per team to have a card at a 90 overall, and there are rules, as you can see on the right of this image. All Playoff Predictor players start at a 90 overall. Players will update every Monday and Friday starting on March 11th based on the playoff standing. So division leader team player items will boost to a 93 overall. Wildcard team player items will boost to a 98 overall. Non-playoff team will stay at a 90 overall. So like these cards will go up and down. So let's say one week the Islanders are in first place. The Islanders player, who is Josh Bailey, will get upgraded to a 93 because they are division leader. But let's say someone surpasses them, they'll go back down to a 90 overall. So it's a very interesting concept, and it's pretty cool. We haven't seen this done in NHL before, so big ups to EA on that for sure. So a new event means a new event objective. So as you can see here, if you complete these all, you get a playoff predictor collectible. You win one game against the current team of the week, 500 coins, 25 jerseys you get, jersey number 69, nice EA, 50 hits, a March monthly collectible, 90 shots, so coins, assistant captain item, that's very cool. Monthly collectible, 500 coins, captaincy item, pretty cool. March collectible, and that is it. So that's pretty cool for the event objectives. You get captaincy items, which is really cool, and collectibles to help you get closer to that legend. As you can see, there are new sets, as there are new set cards. So here they are, playoff predictor sets, and they're pretty self-explanatory here. So Western Conference playoff predictor set, trading any 14 playoff predictor collectibles for a choice of one of three playoff predictor players from the Western Conference. This is from the Eastern Conference, and this is from both conferences. So very interesting. These collectibles will go for a bit, and it's going to be interesting to see what the price of these cards are going to be, with the overalls fluctuating up and down or staying the same. Set means new pack, so we'll go check those out as well. The design on the packs are very cool. So we're going to start off with the smaller pack, the mini playoffs predictor pack. This pack contains 10 items, including 5 player items, 1 guaranteed NHL player, and a chance of a playoff predictor collectible. Not too bad. Here's a probability for that. I guess it's a decent probability for a 25k pack. This is a 50k pack called a premium playoff predictor pack. This pack contains 12 items, including 7 player items, 2 guaranteed NHL player items, and an increased chance of a playoff collectible. Here's a probability at that, 45% for an 83 overall. I guess that's not too bad. Again, it is what it is. We have the extreme playoff predictor pack. This pack contains 22 items, including 16 player items, 4 guaranteed NHL player items, and an increased chance of up to 2 playoff predictor collectibles. Probability on this is very much, I guess, better. You have a chance at an 85 plus overall for 25%, and a chance at an alumni player at a 21%, which is decent, I guess. And we obviously are going to have some new challenges here. So there are 14 challenges here. So if you complete the first one, you get 700 coins, a March monthly collectible, customization pack, 700 coins, 700 coins, and a gold common player, 700 coins, and a monthly collectible, customization pack, contracts pack, a gold common player, a mini playoff predictor pack. So that's cool. We do get that 25k pack for completing this challenge, which is pretty decent. Gold common player, a bronze pack, a March monthly collectible, contracts pack, another collectible, and bronze pack, which isn't too bad. So 25k pack, you can't really complain on that for just playing against the computers on, I believe, pro difficulty. Also have a new competitive season for this event, and we're just gonna go ahead and take a look at the rewards. So it was ranked by round points, not by wins, which I definitely think is better for competitive season. So let's check out the season prizing for this. So there are 2 rounds, 5 days apiece, and you pretty much just get packs for it. Which I don't know. I wish the rewards were better where there's player items, but packs will do, and it is what it is, I guess. Anyways, guys, that's pretty much it for this set. If you guys think it's a cool concept they are doing with the cards increasing and decreasing in overalls every week, if you think that's cool, let me know. I think that is very cool. It's never been done before in any ultimate team game mode, I guess, at least to my understanding. So I think it is very cool. It is something new, and I guess you just got to take a chance on some of these cards. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this set. I really went through everything you guys need to know, and hopefully me showing you this will help you, you know, gauge what you guys want to do towards this event. Anyways, guys, hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. If you guys did, make sure to drop a like and drop a comment down below. I love talking to you guys in the comments. And make sure, if you are new around here, to click the subscribe button. We are on the road to 2,000 subscribers. Anyways, guys, thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace!